Hello students, today we'll start with a new topic, that is agricultural sector during British rule. So during British or colonial rule, India was an agrarian country. That means that most of its population was engaged in agricultural or aligned activities. So at that point of time, though the most of the population was engaged in agricultural work, but still the country was not self-sufficient in food grains. That was the basic problem during British rule. Because of that, the agricultural sector was stagnant. Due to that, the economy was backward also, because most 85% of the population was engaged in this work. Because of all these reasons, the country was a backward economy during British rule. So let's start with the features of agricultural sector during the British rule. Low productivity was a prominent feature during British rule. By low productivity, I mean to say that per hectare production of the good was very low. अगर और मैं डिटेल में बताऊँ तो it means that जो भी एक particular area होता है उसका हम production निकालते हैं तो that was very low during the British rule. I'm not talking about production. Though the production was also very low during British rule, but here I mean to say low productivity, it means that per hectare production of the land, production capacity of the land was very low during the British rule. Because of this reason, the country was not self-sufficient in producing good food grain for its own people. So the cost of production was also very high and the productivity was low. Due to this reason, the farmers usually have loss in the production process, or the outcome of the production process was loss. The basic reason is huge cost, and as the productivity was also low, so there was loss in the production of goods in the country. Yeah, the farmers were having loss by producing goods in the country. One of the prime reason for low productivity was lack of irrigation facility during the British rule or the colonial rule, as no efforts were being taken by the British government to facilitate farmers with the irrigation facility. They have to wait for the monsoon season, or they have to wait for the rainy season to come. If there was huge rain or there was enough rain, that was positively affecting the crops. But if there is low rain during the season, or if there is no rain during the season, the farmers have to bear the consequences. And because of that, the productivity was very low, or because of that, the farmers were facing loss during the production process. One of an important feature of agricultural sector during British rule was subdivision of landholdings. The farmers were having very small landholdings. Because of that, they were not able to use any technical tools on the field, और यू कैन से दैट क्योंकि लैंड होल्डिंग्स इतने छोटे एरिया के होते थे दैट देयर वॉज नो पॉजिटिव इफेक्ट और देयर वॉज नो इनिशिएटिव और मोर इनिशिएटिव बीन टेकन बाय द फार्मर्स. With this point only, I want to drop in one more point that not only the lands were subdivided, but there was also tenant and landlord tendency was going on, or it was the prime feature that the lands were owned by somebody else and the workers on those fields were someone else. So there was no personal attachment or no personal burden that was being taken by the person who was working on the land, because they were not bothered about how much production will be there on that land because that land was owned by someone else. Due to all these four reasons and some other n numbers of reasons, the agricultural sector during the British or the colonial rule was stagnant sector. By stagnancy, I mean to say there was no growth in the production of goods during the tenure or during that period. Due to all these reasons, the country was facing backwardness and there was no initiative taken by the British rule to overcome all these clauses which were there in the agricultural sector.